Hi my loves, what's up and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be all about taming the frizz, getting the best press out at home as possible. Because I don't wear my hair pressed out that much anymore, it's more prone to frizzing. So if you're interested in learning about the new techniques I've been using to help tame my frizz, then keep on watching. First things first, I want to give a huge shout out to TYMO for sponsoring this video. Thank you so much, TYMO. Love that for me. So we're going to be talking about their TYMO ring, right? So basically, it reminds me of like a modern day hot comb, but less damaging, of course, better for your hair, all that good stuff. So I've already opened this box, so everything's not perfect, but I just want to show y'all what comes in it. So you get a cute little hair detangler brush, two clips, which I absolutely love because I use the stainless steel duckbill clips and those things be stabbing my scalp. So I definitely needed those for sure. And then you're going to get this super cute glove, super stretchy, so should fit multiple size hands. And this just helps to protect your hand from the heat, basically, so you don't actually like burn your hand or anything. So yeah, this is all the contents that comes in the box. And then on the lid of the box, as you can see right here, it has directions, instructions on how to use, and just a little bit more information about the tool. So let's get into today's session, okay? So I have started to incorporate an anti-frizz serum. This is the Garnier Fructis. I'm pretty sure y'all are super familiar. I feel like this is like the basic of the basics of anti-frizz serums. If y'all have any suggestions on really good anti-frizz serums, please leave them in the comments below. I do really like this one, but this is drugstore and I feel like there's probably better that I can get that's out there. So please let me know. Like I mentioned in the beginning, I don't wear my hair straight as much as I used to, and I feel like that's why it really frizzes up really bad. So I am really on a journey to find what works best to keep my hair from frizzing when it's straight. Today's blow dryer, I'm going to be using the TYMO Air Hype, just because the whole point of this look and this tutorial is to get your hair as straight as possible in a less amount of time, and the TYMO Air Hype definitely helps to do that. Also uses less heat, and so that's going to be critical to today's tutorial because I am essentially going to be using three hot tools, okay? But y'all, don't faint. I promise you, to me, in my opinion, it feels like less heat than it does with just my regular blow dryer and my flat iron, and I'm going to explain why in a minute, but we're just going to go in with our TYMO Air Hype. I changed the nozzle on the front. I thought I wanted to use the one with the paddle brush, but I really like a comb nozzle. I feel like it just gets my hair as straight as possible. So we're just going to continue going through and blow drying our hair with the TYMO Air Hype. Thank you. Let's get into the TYMO ring. So here I'm just showing you the power button, and then you use the two buttons at the bottom to turn up your heat settings to adjust them higher or lower. So here's tea, sis, okay? Remember when I mentioned at the beginning that I am essentially gonna be using three tools to get my hair straightened? This is going to be what is going to prep my hair for the flat iron. Now, I know that sounds crazy. I know y'all are probably going to be like, wait, what? You're putting even more heat on your hair? But hear me out, okay? Only reason I'm still using a flat iron is because my ends are cut so bluntly. If my ends were not blunt, I could use this TYMO ring by itself and not even need to use the flat iron. And I know what y'all are thinking, okay? Y'all are probably like, yeah, this video is sponsored, whatever. But I don't know if y'all noticed, but I don't really do a ton of sponsored videos because I'm not really in the business of promoting things just to make money. So if I promote something, it's because I genuinely believe in it and I genuinely use it. So when I tell y'all this is now my go-to process to press out my hair, like whenever I want my hair to be straightened, I really mean that. I just love the fact that it cuts the time that it takes for me to get my hair straightened literally in half. So like anything that does that, count me in. And y'all, I don't need nobody coming for my broken off edges. My edges typically are prone to breakage, but I think it's really from the color that I did from dyeing my hair. So never mind that part, but let's get into this piece. So like I said, you can use it upward or downwards. I prefer to use it upwards, but I just wanted to show y'all how straight one pass of this comb will get your hair. You can see the shine here. You can see the straightness. If you look at my roots, excluding my edges, I'm doing my edges now, but just looking at my roots, you can see how flat it got my roots. So this is literally highly recommended, okay? Like literally I recommend. I hate to sound like a broken record, but like I mentioned earlier, the only reason why I use this and still use my flat iron is literally just because of how bluntly cut my ends are. You'll see towards the end how flat this really gets my roots. It's just my ends that still need a little extra bump. So most people will be able to use this in lieu of their flat iron. Like it literally takes place of a flat iron and having to do the chase method with your comb. Like it's amazing. I do recommend using a heat protectant. I did not use a heat protectant just because I never use a heat protectant. My hair isn't really like prone to heat damage like that. And I think it's because, again, I don't really press my hair out as often anymore. But I've never really found heat protectants to be like super beneficial for me. You know, that's just my personal preference. But I do recommend that you use a heat protectant. You have to know your hair and know what's best for your hair. So as with any heating tool, use a heat protectant. However, the TYMO ring does have 5 temperature levels. So based on your hair texture, your hair type, what your hair needs, you have the option from going from 266 degrees Fahrenheit to 410 degrees Fahrenheit. I also love the design of this TYMO ring. Because of the design, like it's virtually impossible to like burn your scalp. Y'all know how we be burning our scalp when we be flat on our hair. Like you literally won't have any of that. So those are a few things that I really love about this. So let's continue on with the style and then we'll come back and chat in a little bit. Thank you. Just a few more things I want to mention about the TYMO ring. So it has a 60 minute auto off. So it auto shuts off after 60 minutes. So you don't have to worry about whether or not you forgot to unplug it. 360 swivel power cord. So it gives you more flexibility with styling. And yeah, you can see here how well it works. This is my roots with just the TYMO ring only. Haven't gone in with a flat iron yet. So it definitely gets your hair super flat without having to flat iron. Like I said before, I just need the flat iron to bump my super blow blunt in. So gonna go back in with a little bit of my anti-frizz serum to prep the hair. And then this first row I bumped a few times, but after this row you'll see I'm literally just going in one pass. That's it. And I'm not even going up the full shaft of the hair, just really on the end. So the proof is in the pudding, sis. Okay. Going to go in with my favorite Hask macadamia serum, or is this the keratin? I think this is the keratin one. Just gives a little added extra shine, especially since my hair is now colored. But yeah, I hope you guys love the results. Like I said, I hope you believe me when I say that yes, I am now using three tools. However, I personally feel like the heat that I'm using on my hair is way less than before because I do not have to go in with nearly as many passes as I did previously. Let me know what you guys think. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in my next video.